Hey there, HBI Guys Model Workshop back with another kit review for you. This is the re-released MPC Deserter 1984 GMC pickup. This is in 1/25th scale, available from Round 2 and any online retailer. I paid $25.99 for this. Got it shipped for free from my favorite online retailer. You can find these anywhere from $25 to $26. To $22, $23 plus shipping, free shipping. You can find them all over the internet right now. They're available to everyone. This ought to make the part scalpers pretty upset because a lot of people have been asking for this kit to be re-released. The latest editions usually sell on eBay for a considerable amount of money. So they re-released this kit. Now this is their retro style boxing called the Deserter. It's got a cool black design. It's got the suspension lift. That cool early 80s, mid-80s square design of the Chevrolet pickups, which is my favorite design of those pickups ever. I really like those. Now you can see on the box, you get a brush guard with winch. You get a set of water slide decals, of course. You get a roll bar with lights. You get the off-road tires with wheels. Now this is a little misleading because they keep showing white letter tires, and the white letter tires are not in the box. They're just black, as we'll see as we go through. You can see the back view. Short box truck looks really cool with a lift like that. And then your standard highly detailed V8. I would guess that would be a 350. Pretty standard for those trucks. So that's the box art, the Deserter box art. Now something on here, when I saw this at first, I thought they were going to include a decal to mimic the cool desert scene. But as we'll see when we go through, there actually is no decal to do such. So let's start taking a look. First thing up will be the manual, and we'll give a little angle down so we can start seeing stuff better. And it's a standard AMT MPC round 2 manual. You're going to assemble your off-road wheels and tires first, then start assembling your block halves. As we move into the fold-out manual, you'll see over here you're starting assembling the engine exhaust. Down here is your suspension. Now if you look closely, you can see that you have the option of adding the lift blocks in or not on the suspension. So you can have it at stock height or lifted height. That's your choice. And then you can see it just goes together as standard. Put the wheels and tires on, put the engine, transmission, transfer case in the chassis frame. Build your interior bucket, put that inside the body, and then go to the back. Put your box on, put your cab on. Feel free to pause this at any time if I'm going a little too quick. With your hood and optional brush guard. Brush guard doesn't have to be used. Tailgate, rear bumper, and then they tell you where to place the decals, the factory, and some of the optional decals, and the roll bar if you want to put it in the back. And it even comes with a box for the bed. So let's put the directions on the side. Start looking at, what should we look at next? The decals. You know you want to see the decals next. This is the sheet. It's not very large. As you can see, there's no Deserter scheme in there. There's no desert scene. That's my fault when I looked at it. I guess it was just a reflection, but the way they painted it made it look like there was going to be a large, cool desert-themed decal in the box. It's got nice GMC logos. I love the red logo, of course. Off-road, it's got some standard license plates, some sponsor stickers. And then you can make it a business truck with the Chuck's 4x4 truck tires and the Get Off the Road in black and white decals. I'll just do it as close to stock as possible. As you can see, there are no grill or tailgate GMC logos. Those will need to be painted, as you can see, since they are not included on the decal sheet. Now here we've got a set of four off-road tires. You don't get any other tires in the kit. These are it. So you do not have the option of stock tires on this kit unless you provide your own. They're the Formula Desert Dog PCV tires. They have nice realistic tread for the time period. They are a hollow tire, as you can see. And they're semi-flexible. It's kind of rigid. They're not wet noodle type rubber. They're a vinyl type tire. Semi-rigid but hollow. Here in the bag, because I do want to build this, so I don't want to get it all scratched up, is the cab glass. You got your windshield and your back glass. They're both clear. They're both attractive. There's no real distortion to worry about. And then your red taillights right there. There is no provision made in the plastic where it's clear, so you'll have to paint your reverse light in there yourself. We have a nice chrome tree. It's a standard size chrome tree, not too small. On that tree, we can see the rear bumper. We can see the grill. Now, if you look in there, you got your GMC logo you have to paint, and it's got turn signals up in the top of the grill and the four headlight system. It's got some optional smaller wheels, the bullet hole wheels, the revolver wheels. There's no tires in the kit that fit those, but they are in there for you to use if you so choose with something else. We got the front bumper with turn signals in it, which would be indicative of an older GMC. You could fill those. You strip your chrome and fill those if you wanted and re-chrome. We've got your back tailgate insert. Very familiar. I owned a GMC Jimmy, so I know exactly what that looks like. I always like the GMC logo over the Chevys, even though they're pretty much the exact same truck. You've got your off-road light bezels, your mirrors, your side cab steps, your little drop steps there. Got your valve covers, your carburetors, and then we've got the nice big off-road wheels, the mag wheels. Now, I would like to strip these and paint them white so they look like wagon wheels. Very common for those days. Nice set of cheap off-road wheels. A lot of people bought them back then. Now, we'll start looking at some of the smaller parts. The rest of the kit is molded in white plastic, and I'm going to start getting some of it out here, and then we'll go through one by one. We've got a nice dashboard. Very much looks like a General Motors dash from a pickup back then. No decals provided for the dashboard whatsoever. Get out the toothpicks. Steering wheel. Looks like the plastic General Motors steering wheel. We've got a radiator. We've got a firewall. We've got a radiator support. We've got the nice hood, which is nice and straight and smooth on the top. Underneath, it does have the proper webbing, but it also has slits you can cut out if you wanted to add a blower to the truck. Either a small one or a very large one. So that's your option if you want to make it a real big monster truck. And then we've got the bucket seats. Bucket seats are no fun if you have a girlfriend in a cool pickup like that she can't slide over. Now on here we've got the truck box. This is what I showed you in the directions. I didn't really know what it was till I saw the directions. We've got our tailgate. And you can see where the insert goes there. Let Mr. Camera focus here. White plastic's really hard to focus on. And the inside of the tailgate. We've got a sway bar. Right here are your suspension blocks. That gives you your lift. You've got your shocks. You got your wheel backs. More wheel parts. On this plastic part here, we've got our interior bucket. You can see the pedals are molded in and the door panels are molded in from the factory. Makes it a little more difficult to paint, but it's an older kit. It's a re-release. Hasn't been out in a long time and it's worth quite a bit, so I guess we're just going to have to deal with it. Till somewhere the Model Gods release an all-new, new-style mold, sort of like Mobius did with the Fords. Wouldn't you love to see some of that? There's your brush guard. There's your rear roll bar with light bar, light bezels, and this cool little doodad here should be your winch that mounts onto that brush guard on the front. We've got a couple more small parts trees, very small parts. Now, 1, 2, 3, and 4. On this tree, we've got the exhaust. That's pretty self-explanatory. We've got some molding, we've got the air cleaner, and transfer case and drive shafts. Drive shaft 1, drive shaft 2. Self-explanatory, we know where those go. We've got our differentials, front and rear. You can tell which one's the front, which one's the rear by offset. And the steering bar. And rear suspension, rear differential. Big ejector pin mark right on the top of it. But that should be the side that faces the top of the truck, so only people that drop your truck on the floor are going to notice that. You can see those. They look pretty good. It's an older kit, but one thing you have to notice, I wanted to make sure I went over, I'll bring this back. A lot of flash on some of the suspension stuff. A lot of extra plastic, so It's an older kit. The molds are probably really old. You're going to have to work at it a little bit for this one. On this part here, we've got another sway bar. We've got an extra body part here. It might be a visor. You guys tell me what this is. That part right there. We've got another additional optional brush guard, sort of like the one they had on the General Lee. We've got a center console with cup holders, the birth control hump, and we got some shocks. Here's the engine. I'm just going to guess, say it's a 350 or at least a 305. We got block and transmission halves. We've got regular valve covers. You can go with the chrome ones that are on the chrome tree. Cylinder heads, intake, oil pan, all separate. Stock air cleaner, pump cover. You've got optional headers, brake booster. Come on, focus. Fan. Exhaust manifolds, and various bits and parts like starter, battery. Maybe even this might be an optional CB radio. See if we can get the camera to focus on it. I can't really tell, though. Windshield washer bottle and whatnot. Now, here's the body. You can see it's a short box. Let's turn around. And we've got the frame chassis one piece. You can see underneath with the fuel tank and the spare, which is much smaller than what's on the truck, of course, because it's underneath. And then on the top, they've got some detail molded in of the fender liners and the frame of the body. The box is here. This has still got the inserts cut in it for the Fall Guy edition. So you'll have to fill those if you want a factory truck without the storage box. Or you can leave them in there. Most people might not even notice. Tail lights, the box is all one piece. It's nicely molded. Looks nice to me. And then the main cab. Now mine is really deep where they molded the tops of the doors in. Can you see that? So check yours, see if it's deep like that. You might want to have to do a little rework or fixing, or you can leave it as it is and work around it. But that's how mine looks. So some may look like that, some may not. But both of my upper parts of the door are pretty sunken in with the trim that they have to try to mold in there, that drip rail. Handles are on. So it's not a bad looking. It definitely has the shape of the truck. So that's it right there, folks. That's the MPC re-released deserter kit. I like it. I think it's worth the price just because of the fact that it's hard to find anywhere else. All the parts are there to make yourself a really nice short box GMC pickup with a small lift on it. Or if you want to use those other wheels and tires from another kit and build it with the stock suspension, you can do so. So you can have a pretty stock truck. You're just going to have to deal with those box seams and maybe, you know, argue a little bit about the turn signals. You know, this doesn't show them in the grill, but then they're in the grill on the kit. And it also has the bumper with the tail with the turn signals in them, which is an earlier release of the GMC. So thanks for watching HPI Guys Model Workshop. My quick little review here. Hope you enjoyed it. Leave your comments below if you have any suggestions or if you have any information of stuff that I missed. Thanks for watching.